Good afternoon, evening, whatever we are, YouTube. I was watching a video on a channel called VC131A. The video is called Taking Dahlia Cuttings. Now, my dad was rather famous in our neighborhood for his dahlias, and he never ever propagated by cutting. So I didn't know this could even be done. So we bought a wee purple dahlia. Dahlia purple and white at the nursery next door to experiment with taking cuttings. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to actually mix up the same potting medium that he uses.
Ah. It's snowing.
And inside?
His potting medium is one part vermiculite or perlite, and we're going to use perlite for this just because I have more of it than I have vermiculite. One part peat moss and one part sand. So don't breathe in the vermiculite dust. Ah, really should be wearing a mask for doing this, but those have become too valuable to waste on dust these days. Okay, one part vermiculite. One part sand. One part peat moss. Thank you. So, we have... only two places where we can take cuttings at this moment. There's lots of little side shoots coming off on this one. That's why we chose it. But you need to have a minimum of four leaves in order to do this. Oops, that's it. Throw the thing on the floor. Ow. So you cut your dahlia cutting just below a leaf node. Pull off the two lower leaves. Nope, that's full of it. Pull off the lower leaves and dip in rooting hormone. I don't really know what type of rooting hormone is best. This is what I've got, so this is what I'm going to use. And firm it in a little bit. There we are, humidity dome. This was used to plant in, so it's got a couple of air holes to keep the humidity from building up too much and preventing airflow. And we're going to do exactly the same thing. If I can actually pick up the cup. Now, if we were taking these cuttings from an older part of the plant, oops, I cut that a little lower than I needed to. What he suggests is dahlia leaves are three-lobed. He suggests you cut the center lobe off to help reduce transpiration. So we're going to do that on this one. The one from the other side didn't have developed enough leaves to do that too. Now, as I said, my dad was famous in our neighborhood for his dahlias. When I was growing up. And since he stopped growing them, I have never been able to successfully overwinter any Dahlia bulbs. But this will give me, we hope, small plants that we can overwinter. No, babe, turn it around. Hook the back hook. The caulking gun just fell off the rack behind my wife.
Okay. You need to impale me.
So this is what we're going to be doing. So from this one plant, I should be able to get an endless supply of cuttings. See, right now there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 sprouts started on this. So we're going to take cuttings from that for a while, and then we will plant it out in a, probably in a root pouch. I think maybe the seven gallon root pouches we might use for the dahlias, so that we can remember to bring them in the fall. We always seem to be too rushed. So there's our 33-33-33 mixture of peat moss, sand, and perlite. I chose the perlite over the vermiculite because I have seeds for Sarsinia purpurea, the indigenous pitcher plant, carnivorous pitcher plant for our area of Ontario, and it says to, the instructions for it say to put it in a sand, peat, and perlite mixture, and those seeds were very expensive. They were just slightly less than $1 a piece. So I'm going to do it exactly the way they said to. And they will be started in this stuff. So there's our latest experiment in plant propagation. Dahlia cuttings just in a low-nutrient medium, and we'll see how that works. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. With my love and leave this lobby.